Hi, this is a short video to show you the different ways to add stones on a curve. So I go to the gems on curve, and the curve that I want to apply the stones is this one. Alright, so I have the stones, and just say that I want a stone from this point to this point. So here in the gems on curve tool, I have the spacing method. That this is what I want to talk about. So we have three different spacing methods. All right, so I'm going to tell you each of them what it's for. So let me get the bigger stones. So I will go with 2 millimeter stones, 2.4. All right, so I have these stones. So now when I have the gem spacing method minimum, and I have a spacing of 0.2. What this method is doing is that from the moment that I start to move, as you can see now, I'm increasing the space between the stones. But when the software finds that he can add another stone and keep them, all of them, with a distance of 0.2, it adds me another stone. So now I am almost there. So he's calculating, the software is calculating, and bam, from here to here, getting all the distance between the stones, the software calculates that can add another stone, keeping the minimum of 0.2. So this is the first method. Then we have another method that it's called gem spacing method minimum scaled. So the behavior here is the same that I was talking to you, but instead moving the stones, adding the stones, what are we doing here is just making the stone bigger. All right, so as you can see now, the stones are getting bigger, keeping the distance to 0.2, but when the software calculates that he can add another stone with these dimensions that we set up, keeping the 0.2, then decrease the stones again to the original size to keep the 0.2 and the 0.2 and the stones at the size that we choose at the very beginning. And then the third method is the gem spacing method fix. This is to keep always the same space in the between the stones. So it's 0.2, I can keep moving. And as you can see at the end, once the software finds that can add another stone, keeping this distance, adds another stone. All right, so depending on what kind of design you are doing, the three of them can be useful. So it's just a video to give you a bit of clarity on this behavior. As you can see here, we are running the last version, the release candidate, where we have a lot of new improvements. This will be ready in October 2019, so hope you like it.